We did it.
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 Oh, we did it.
We did it. We did it.
We did it.
We did it. We did it. Mural breakdown in December. Welcome, fellow artists, to Lyricology 101. I still don't have a tagline yet. This week, we'll be doing a bar-for-bar breakdown of Logic's second verse from the song Gang Related off of his album Under Pressure. So Logic did all of these words to the vote on the Eminem breakdown, but there was something really interesting this time around. There are a huge amount of debates, like more than I've ever seen on any of the breakdown videos, especially on a vote. And they were arguing whether or not that Logic was overrated. I personally see Logic as like a bridge for these new generation hip-hop listeners that are sick of these mumble rappers and want more. Logic has an incredible ability to manipulate and flip flows, as well as having a really good ear for beats. He has really creative concepts, and he's a really good, humble dude. Like, I actually like him outside of rap as well. I ended up choosing Gang Related because it shows off his storytelling skills, but also, some of you Logic fans are kind of like Eminem stans. You guys were a little bit crazy about this song in particular. You guys really wanted the second verse, so I'm going to give you guys the second verse. I personally thought the first was better, but we'll just hop into the second verse. Fuck it. So if you're new to this process, I'll be breaking this song down from a standpoint focusing primarily on technique, but also looking at some meanings. If you want the entire meaning of the song, I highly suggest you go to Rap Genius. I'll be going over Logic's flow, rhyme schemes, concept, and any other literary devices or tricks. This breakdown is designed to show aspiring artists unique ways to approach their songwriting, while also just showing others the intricacies of hip-hop songwriting. We'll be covering the second verse, 16 bars. But first, let's look at the concept of the track. This song is a story told from two perspectives. The first verse given the mindset of Logic when he was younger, and the second verse given the mindset of his older brother. Both give their thoughts on living in the crazy conditions of their environment. Logic's perspective is nearly helpless since the conditions happening around him were outside of his control. His brother's perspective is a bit darker, so let's explore that. All right, let's dive in!
Living life like this, hope little Bobby never fight like this. Stab a motherfucker with a knife like this. All about the money on a night like this. Run up in the crib, put a bullet in your rib. Got a lot of gear, but I never had a chance. Never had a chance. Yeah.
Logic has been blessed with a fantastic voice. It's damn near perfect for rap. He tends to articulate all of the sounds in his words. He doesn't slur or mumble his words, but he does use stylistic inflections in his sounds. In other words, he makes his words sound cool. So usually artists that overpronounce their words end up sounding a bit nerdy or maybe even mechanical and forced, but he found a way to make it sound natural and interesting. What's interesting is since Logic is taking on the perspective of his brother for this verse, he brings a slightly different performance compared to the first verse. Although subtle, he pronounces his words differently. There's a bit of drag to his syllables, more pauses and stops in his verse. There's a sense of weariness in the expression of his lyrics. A quick note to add is that the instrumental is a bit slow, which allows more time between the beats in each bar. With more time between each beat, there's more room for lyrics and cadences. I'll try to focus more on flows because this is really one of Logic's strengths. In the first couplet, Logic quickly chops up the syllables in his words until he gets to the second and fourth beat of each bar, where he drags the sounds in the last three words. On the second bar, he phrases eight syllables before he drags the final three. For the second couplet, he places emphasis on five-syllable phrasing that focuses on the last syllable in the group. When he gets to the end of both bars, he drags the last three words again. A good way to describe phrasing is a group of words that are said in a specific way that highlights a pattern. Logic uses a three-syllable rhyme scheme in the first couplet with repeating words on the last two syllables. I personally don't count those as rhymes, but this song is about narrative and not about technique. We have some two-syllable internals with the is sounds, then we finish with a repeated three-syllable phrase. This is a callback to the first couplet in the previous verse, showing how different the perspective is between both brothers. The older brother is out on the streets surviving, wishing that Logic will never have to fight for his life like he has to. This shows that he's doing what needs to be done for money, which parallels with the end of the second bar in the first verse. Logic's perspective sees the hood is up to no good at night. His brother's perspective admits that he himself is up to no good in order to get this money. This is alluding to the fact that he had the potential to go on another path in life, but the conditions that he ended up trapped in forced him to fall into the lifestyle that he's currently describing. He repeats the line to place emphasis on how unfair this realization is.
Stay strapped, but I hate it when I take it out. If you want it, I'ma lay it out. I'm a little brother, make it out. Every night when I pray, about, what I pray about, check it, yeah, got a son on the way, but I cling to the streets even though I wanna run away. I imagine a better life, why I never had a dead of life, hit you with the in the dead of night.
Logic starts the first bar early. The first beat doesn't start until the word strapped. For the first bar, he places emphasis on seven-syllable phrases in his sentences. He then follows up the next bar with five-syllable phrasing, but then he trails off. So I don't know if this was a mistake in the recording or if this was another layer to his brother's character. Maybe being unfocused and flustered, but in my personal opinion, I don't know, I felt like it broke the narrative for me, and it came off sloppy. Please let me know what you guys think, because maybe it's just me. He starts the third bar early. The first beat doesn't start until the word sun. He slows his sentence down to fill the first two beats in the bar. Then he goes back to the quick chop syllables to finish the bar. This last bar has a nice rhythm technique, so the first sentence takes up some time because he stretches the word imagine. The next two sentences places emphasis on seven-syllable phrasing. The gunshots in the instrumental take up two slots where there could have been syllables. There are three shot sounds, but the third shot actually lands exactly on the point where Logic uses the word in. So in total, what you guys are hearing is a seven-syllable group of sounds. So what he really said was hit you with the pop-pop in the dead of night. Logic uses three-syllable rhymes in the first couplet using repeated phrases again. We get a quick two-syllable internal rhyme in the first bar and five-syllable internal in the second bar. We get isolated rhymes in the third and fourth bars. There are some three-syllable rhymes with some internals matching the E sound and the sounds. We get more three-syllable rhymes with an internal matching the A sound, the S sound, and the I sounds. His brother is forced to have a gun when living this lifestyle. He doesn't want to have to shoot anyone, but if there's a situation that requires using it, so be it. He prays that Logic will find a way to get out of the hood and never experience these horrors firsthand. This emphasizes more pressure for Logic's brother, not just a pressure, but maybe a motivation to get this money by any means necessary. He doesn't want to live like this, but he doesn't have a choice. He wants something better in life. I really wish this line was on another bar or something. I feel like he could have used this space to give the listener another moment to feel compassion for his brother's position.
We went from getting in depth with his emotional state, then suddenly jumping back to killing people. Now, he's already mentioned in the beginning of the verse that he has to kill people, and then later on he's going to once again mention that he has to kill people. And I feel like he used up that opportunity to actually continue the emotional description of what he was going through. It just seems like a little small missed opportunity, you know? Just don't hurt me!
Selling crack to my own pops, pushing his weight on my own block. If I sell a brick, I could buy a house. If they find a key, they might lock me up. But I take the chance cause I need that shit and don't give a fuck. Take the chance cause I need that shit and don't give a fuck.
This is a moment in the performance where you can hear Logic is really trying to channel the attitude of his brother, especially in the last couplet. This time around, he isn't doing too much chopping. He uses less words and shorter phrasing in this quatrain. I feel like he slowed it down to place more weight on the lyrics and give you guys a break before the next quatrain. We get a two-syllable rhyme on the first bar and a one-syllable internal on the next bar. The last three bars share a single syllable. Some internals with the I sound and the I sound. This really shows how desperate the situation is. He's not only selling crack to the people in his community, but to his own father. It doesn't matter how he gets this money, he's going to get it. We get some word association with drugs. A brick is a kilo, and a kilo is also known as a key. The parallel is that a house could be made of bricks and also requires keys. Being locked up is an idiom for going to prison. Also a quick play on opposites with selling and buying. So in context, if he sells a brick, he'll be able to buy whatever he needs to be comfortable and to provide for his family. But if they find that brick, he'll end up in prison. But obviously he doesn't care because the risk is worth it.
And now you're about to get hit with the machine gun.
Get down or lay down, hit you with the Beretta, you better stay down. Straight shots on the playground, living how I'm living with the life that I'm giving. Anybody that's riding with me, I'm riding with him. Show me the enemy and I'ma hit him. The second I bit him, I get him and hit him with the venom. Ain't no need to pretend I'ma never do it. I knew it, I've already been through it. I do it for the street, for the fam, for the life. Anybody that's gang related.
We're hit with a barrage of chopped syllables, and he butchers the bar line due to the fact that he's filling up the bars with as many words as possible. The first bar places emphasis on dragged two-syllable phrases surrounded by chopped words. The second bar starts with a focus on four-syllable phrasing, then transitions into five-syllable phrasing. The third bar starts with six-syllable phrasing, moving into four-syllable phrasing. We wrap things up with two-syllable phrasing, going to three-syllable phrasing, and ending with a slow release that concludes with the instrumental.
His precision is undeniable.
We start with a two-syllable rhyme in the first bar, leading into a three-syllable barrage throughout the following bars. Then we end the final bar with two-syllable rhymes. We get some internals with the A sound, the sound, the S sound, and the I sound. This entire passage is really a summary of the gang member mentality. You're either with us or against us. I'll shoot whoever tries me. I don't care where we are.
You got my back, I got yours. If anyone's got a problem, consider it handled. This is not a lie. I do this for the hood, and I do this for my family. And there you have it. See, we get a great look at his storytelling ability, and then we also get to view the complexity of his flows. I can definitely understand his appeal, but at the same time, I can also see why a person would argue that he's overrated. At the end of the day, Logic is necessary, and also Logic worked his ass off to get in the position that he's in today. He's definitely a step above current so-called rappers, so yeah. If there are any other Logic tracks you'd like me to cover in the future, let me know in the comments. Also, if you'd like to buy Under Pressure, I'll have an Amazon affiliate link below. So if you click the link, anything that you purchase on Amazon will kick a percentage back to me, no extra charge to you. There won't be a vote this week, only because I'm going to be doing the mural breakdown all of December, so I'm actually working on it right now. Fuck. If you guys don't know, we've been sponsored by Audible.com, a totally awesome place for audiobooks. You get a free month and a free audiobook if you sign in through our special link at audibletrial.com/lyricology101. That's audibletrial.com/lyricology101. I'll have a link in the description below. A book that I personally suggest for artists and procrastinators alike is Stephen Pressfield's The War of Art. It's one of my favorite books, and I feel like it'll really help you guys develop as artists, and also for those that seem to be in a creative medium, but you just constantly procrastinate or prevent yourself from completing your task. This book is essential. It'll change your life. And this is my personal recommendation. This is one of the easiest and cost-free ways that you guys can support Lyricology 101. If you guys love the show, if you guys like what I do with the breakdowns, this is one of the ways you can keep the show alive. I'm trying really hard to keep Lyricology going, and this is actually one of the easiest opportunities for all of us. So if you guys want to help out the channel, I have a number of ways you guys can support, but I really suggest the Audible way. It's super easy, and if you guys don't like the service, you can cancel as soon as you want, whenever you want, and it's no cost to you, and you get to keep your audiobook. So if you want to help a brother out, just trial Audible, and we can trade book recommendations and be book homies or something. I don't know. Fuck. Thank you for watching. Feel free to like and subscribe, and if you like what we're doing here at Lyricology 101, please share. If you'd like to get in contact with me, I have more information in the description below. If you guys don't do descriptions, then I'll put information right here. There it is. Look at all that information. This was Lyricology 101. I'm Andre Gaynor. And don't forget where the art is. Thank you guys for watching another episode of Lyricology 101. I really appreciate the support, man. I really love you guys. This is so awesome that I even get to do this. Click the links, subscribe, check out our Patreon. There's a lot of great stuff that you guys can check out. There's more breakdowns, we got rap tips, and we have so much more coming. I'm trying to figure out this 20-second shit. I don't know how long, like, if I'm going too long or if I'm going too short. I don't have a timer or anything, so hopefully it doesn't just randomly cut off on me.